What's going on, everybody? My name is Chris, aka RoboPack92, and you are watching the Shared Screens reaction to the Xbox Summer Games Showcase. We got the best crew on the planet Earth out here reacting today. We got Alec Bobko, we got Chance, we got Jordan Deeb, we got Jim Tasty. We're all here and excited to see what Xbox is bringing to us this year. There's been some positive stuff going around. I'm really excited about it. I don't know if you guys want to keep doing introductions. I kind of just want to see what Xbox has for us.
I'm right there with you.
I'm down to jump in.
Let's roll it!
Minecraft 2.
Oh my god.
A second Minecraft has come out.
A second Minecraft has hit the tower.
To craft.
I should probably unmute it.
There we go.
Now, we'll interpret what they're saying.
Oh, we're finally doing this, are we? Because I was going to make a sandwich.
I know that voice.
Damn. Yeah, that does sound real familiar.
Yeah, Let's do it.
Mine looks just like him.
Dave.
I'm going to turn this up a little bit. Sorry, stream.
Heroes? Well, we've all seen them, haven't we? Swanning about the place with their disproportionately high cheekbones and comically massive weapons. Roughing up bandits, because they like to rough up bandits, don't they?
Fable?
I think it's Fable. Yeah, it said Playground.
Is this actually Fable?
On a day-to-day basis,
it's Playground. They're working on it.
Breaking new ground with fruit, with veg, on the agricultural
side
of
things. Fable, nice. Just look at
them. Not wafting around mythical creatures.
Definitely is capturing the vibe.
That's what we're
like. Oh, yeah, I used to kick chickens all the time in the first Fable.
Here. To slay legendary beasts. I'm here to conquer the vegetable, not a euphemism. Let's face it, the age of heroes is over. This is the age of innovation. This, if you will, is the age of death. One moment.
What's this?
Please let him be a giant and that beanstalk just went up to him. Yes, let's go!
Oh my god, dude!
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Yo, this is sick. Cool.
Xbox needed to bring the games. I'm liking what I've seen so far.
Nice.
Let's go!
That's a great show.
Yes!
Yeah.
Did you get a date?
Dang, he's dead.
Oh, Game Pass, baby, day one of Game Pass. Starting out with the heat, bro. You'd love to see it.
World premiere.
People been needing to see that game. That was a.
They actually had a voiceover for world premiere.
Oh, at the game studios too.
Compulsion.
That's so exciting, man. Look at them starting off with Fable like that. That's so great.
Really liking this art style so far.
Yeah.
Give me them Sekiro hands all day, baby. Don't have no mercy in this land.
Don't have no mercy in this land. He'll come to your house and it won't stay long. You get the Black Plague, bro. And somebody be
gone. Death don't have no mercy. Disheveled hand, multiple fingers. Tears of the Kingdom influence everywhere, guys.
More spoken to,
bro,
yeah.
That's exactly what I was thinking. Bounce.
Been a while.
Five spoken.
So
another giant.
What?
2024, year of the giants.
I'm looking for a creature.
You think that applies to football as well, or just video games?
Teeth like knives.
He's missing an eyeball.
Ew.
And most of his face.
We've all got our flaws.
Yeah, we got a Rolly though.
Well,
hey, how about you guys? No. Nobody?
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Turn around.
Not helpful.
It's
right behind me, isn't it?
Sneaky.
Jordan, why are we the same person sometimes?
I don't know. I love it and I hate it all.
Do the meme of sharing one brain cell.
I was about to say, what? You got the brain cell gift from Corey, right?
Cool. Another game pass, so gotta love that.
Song was dope. I'm in on that.
I love this graphic.
I might have liked Forspoken more if it was on Game Pass.
World premiere. I might have played it if it was on Game Pass, you know?
Yo! These are dangerous times.
At least that's what I was not expecting this year. I didn't think we were going to get it here either.
What?
Monday.
They're everywhere.
Oh, yeah.
But the world here.
Right, we got on.
What?
Oh, it's the Syndicate?
Syndicate, okay.
I want to survive. She's playing Spock.
I have to play their game. Looks like I'm all in.
Give me the little axolotl.
I'm gonna fucking cry.
On second thought. I'm out.
Nice.
Also, fucking bar fights. Bounty hunters. Cool.
Swoop.
Oh, hell yeah.
I've been held back my whole life.
Yo.
And now, I just need a chance to finally be free.
Wow.
Wherever that takes me.
I'm here to offer you a way out, okay?
Get off my ship, Jalen.
You look so much like Kyle Katarn.
He does look like Kyle Katarn.
It'll be dangerous, risky.
But is that a K? Is that a K series robot she's walking around with?
Yeah.
Over your shoulder again.
Yo, the drift. So this is definitely a single player game, the way they're showing it.
Yeah, I'm not getting multiplayer vibes from this. It's cool to see the Pike Syndicate in a game, though.
Galaxy out there,
mm-hmm.
And I'm gonna risk it all.
Star Wars Outlaws! What a fucking name, dude!
Next year,
let's fucking go!
Oh, let's go!
Gameplay walkthrough reveal tomorrow!
Let's go!
Yes!
Okay. Yes!
Let's go, dude!
Fable, South of Midnight.
I'm not gonna lie, I really wish they would have shown gameplay. We've been waiting for this for a while. I know it's just tomorrow, but that's like my number one gripe.
I mean, it makes sense that Ubisoft got their own thing. They're gonna wait to show the big stuff.
Yeah, I was expecting to see all of it tomorrow.
Starfield. Gaming is the most powerful of all entertainment. It transports, it challenges, it connects us, and it's just incredibly and awesomely fun. That is why Team Xbox is committed to building the greatest place to play. By partnering with the most ambitious of game creators, and by unleashing the power of the gaming community.
Yeah, I was not expecting that to be here today.
No, not at all. I assume tomorrow, and obviously we still are, but getting a reveal here was very cool.
From mobile devices to PCs to consoles.
Shout out to Xbox holding on to the last vestiges of E3 with a presentation.
I know, right?
Yeah.
These are the works of
Xbox refuses to let E3 die.
We made this.
I love their set every year too. Like this always
the
looks so good.
Most engaged and globally
and shout
diverse
to them
fan base in
for
Xbox
giving the option
history.
To watch it in 4K.
You are
yeah.
This stream, if we wanted to,
your
could be in 4K.
Your passion drives us, and you are the inspiration for the visionaries whose games we showcase today. From
we gotta make some content, so we gotta
all
bump
of the
it down
team
to
at Xbox. Thank you.
It is what it is. You know, you gotta do what you gotta
this
do.
The sacrifices
Lotus,
we make for you guys.
Spiritfarer.
But it's
combat roots with an amazing.
Did you guys ever play
Spiritfarer? Focused action game that is uniquely
no, I never did.
Theirs.
My wife loves it.
All right,
I downloaded
everybody.
It, but just never got around to
it's
playing
time.
It.
It's time.
My wife loves it.
World premiere.
Galaxy premiere.
Hades 2?
Oh, multiplayer. They didn't say that, though, yeah.
Battle Royale.
They said it was an action game. Which Spiritfarer was not.
Right. Digging this art style, though.
Yeah.
Roguelite elements, kind of seems like.
Yeah, that's what I'm assuming. I don't even know 33 gamers. I don't even think I have 33 friends, bro.
Me when I'm the 34th friend in the squad.
God damn it, I'm the 34th wheel again.
There's like a group out there of exactly 34 people. They're like, God damn it.
Like, fuck.
The entire family can play this game.
33 immortals.
Cool.
33 immortals of Elysium Phoenix Rising.
Game Pass again.
That's a big reason I like the Xbox. It's like, what games do I want?
Oh, Payday.
Payday. Payday 3?
Just in and out. Will I not have to pay for this next year?
Yeah. Like, at the very least, Game Pass is a fantastic demo service. No loss in trying any of these games. And I think it's also great for...
Everybody
like smaller, like Indian AA titles.
Oh, absolutely,
too, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Get a lot of exposure.
Yeah.
Perfect Dark.
Do we think this is Payday 3, or is it just coming to Game Pass?
I think it's a new
it's
Payday.
Payday 3.
Payday 2 came out like 10 years ago.
True.
So they ported it a bunch, so I feel like we're due for a new one.
And like, it does look better.
I was just gonna say, this looks like a better engine.
The beat is hot, though.
Payday always had really good music.
It's Payday 2 is free on Epic right now.
It'd be a sign that sequels coming out, get revitalized the brand, put out the most recent game for free, and get people hyped.
Yeah.
Peace. Payday 3. Ooh, that's soon.
Wow, September 21st.
Game Pass. Yep.
Dude, that's how you get people to play Payday, honestly, man. You give it away.
Yeah.
you make it available for free. Like,
world premiere.
Play with your friends, people that make content, probably make content around it. I mean, who doesn't want to rob a bank with it?
Let's go.
Ooh, here comes the persona. For all you fucking weebs.
Yes.
Wouldn't be me.
Yes.
I only play games with buff bald dudes as the main character.
Plays God of War exclusively.
This song is a bang.
There were still like rumors about it, but they need to include both the FS content and the portable content.
There wasn't rumors. There was a leak.
Yeah, they straight up posted the whole, all of the information.
This UI looks so cool.
I mean, I joked about this being for Wii, but really, just once Persona makes the Final Fantasy switch into no longer being turn-based, I'll try one out.
They never will.
Reload.
Then I'll never play it, because I'm not a fucking weeb.
Early?
Yes, you are.
You like Pokemon, man.
That's the only anime I watch, is Pokemon. And I feel like that doesn't count, because it's fucking Pokemon.
If it's Pokemon, it doesn't count, bro.
World premiere.
Not a world premiere.
Sorry about that, everybody. Had some issues on my
hand. Do you think Age of Empires? Assassin's Creed, maybe?
Ooh, if they remaster Black Flag.
Mountain Blade. Obsidian.
It's Avowed? Very much, do they?
Sent here to the living lands. Really liking that pop of color in that.
Yeah.
Guns.
Guns. He's got guns.
Oh, Velociraptor, man.
I think this is Avowed.
It seems to be corrupting our very souls. Hey, what was the name of that 33 game?
33
Immortals.
33 Immortals.
Yeah. But the truth is. Well, thank you. My wife was asking.
Does Avowed have a release window yet?
No. They really haven't talked about it since they announced it, so. Gotcha. Like a first, like, look at it.
Yeah, I mean, that's the vibes I'm getting.
I mean, yeah, it's very Elder Scrolls.
Skyrim, but with guns and zombies. People also like
I mean, that's kind of what Obsidian does, though, right? They take Bethesda games and make them better.
That's fair. Forge.
But I mean, this is gonna not be much more different from my original Skyrim playthrough that I modded. Now that you have
all this... Yeah, but this one has guns.
And you're forging your own destiny. What are you gonna do
with it? That orc design reminds me of that one Will Smith Netflix movie.
Oh yeah. Where the orc is a cop.
Yeah.
Avowed. Let's go, dude.
Yeah, man. Woo. That looks tight. Game Pass.
Mm-hmm. Next year. All right.
Man, 2024 is shaping up to be a pretty good year.
At least for Xbox.
I mean, Xbox needs it, bro.
Yeah.
Xbox again.
Next year is when the dominoes finally fall.
I'm very excited for Avowed.
It only took 3 years into the life cycle.
Ooh, I mean, Rare? Since 2017,
Sea of Thieves,
Rare and Lucasfilm.
Oh, Indiana Jones, like, DLC or something?
Sea of Thieves, yeah. I was about to say, I was like, Sea of Thieves is the only game that Rare makes these days.
Yeah.
It's really good, though. I'm not saying that to...
Wild, but...
I'm not saying that to clown on them. I think Sea of Thieves is very, very good. No fucking way!
That makes way more sense than
Indiana. That's cool.
That's a crossover. Just like when they did Pirates of the Caribbean, this is a crossover that makes perfect sense.
Mm-hmm.
Monkey Island's really, really good. Which ship is right for you? A big ship? A
luxury ship? A ship with just a splash of je ne sais quoi? I really like how his jacket, like the pattern, is like moving as he, like it's staying static as he's moving. They have such a cool art style in this game. What do you think you're doing? Would not be my first choice, but it's so awesome. So I
see you have a meeting. Yeah, there's Guybrush. And I guess it's not every day that you get to meet the mighty pirate Guybrush Threepwood, the legend of Monkey Island. They're also very fun games, the Monkey Island games.
Guybrush.
And the music, this theme remix they're doing is so good.
Nice. You need these.
I know Sea of Thieves is mostly like a multiplayer game. They've done a really good job of adding like tons of campaign content that you can play solo. Highly recommend doing the regular stories, doing the Pirates of the Caribbean one. Jump into this one. Like, they're very, very fun. Especially if you can even find like one other person to run through it with you. Excellent.
For free.
Excellent. Love Sea of Thieves. Comes out next month. Let's go.
That's what they did with the pirates. Yeah. Like,
getting closer and closer to a shadow trap.
Sea of Thieves out here killing it.
First we got nothing, then we got a window, then we got like a more detailed window, then we got a date, now we got next month. At this rate, there'll be four games shadow trap.
One of them came out yesterday, we didn't even know.
It's over.
Yeah.
Ooh, flight sim.
Oh, okay.
Are they adding a campaign to flight sim?
Yeah.
Okay, aerial firefighting.
Canada do some of that right now.
San Andreas started off.
Yeah. Search and rescue.
That one movie with Mark Wahlberg?
I was gonna let the San Andreas one just like kind of go under because that's exactly what I thought. Search and rescue was a little bit too far out there.
Air ambulance.
Drop testing.
I do that a lot.
Mountain rescue.
Children, all of you.
Can you hit them?
Can you also jump out of the plane and just like when they skydive, you also leap?
Yeah. You have to get back in the plane like Travis Pastrana or some shit.
Game of Thrones.
Oh yeah, Game of Thrones, the show known for all its airplanes.
I think he's saying that's King's Landing.
I'll say one thing with, assuming this is Flight Simulator, this, it looks so good.
Yeah.
And the fact that a lot of it's just
executive transport, bro, you can, in a video game, you can contribute to global warming by flying rich people around.
This is like a new game.
Oh, a new one.
All this game is attributing to global warming. You're just flying.
Yeah. But a new iteration, that's cool.
Yeah, that is super hard.
Good for those of you that like those
and
games.
Adding all those like niche subcategories.
Oh, Dune?
Oh, yeah.
They're adding the fucking the Thopter to Flight Sim.
Dune 2. Dune, where's my car?
Dune, where's my car?
Fuck.
I wonder if 2024 will still have all of the sweet, like Top Gun stuff.
Top Gun Maverick?
Yeah. And the Pelican.
Do they like implement like the past kind of stuff like that?
Oh, that's I don't know. Because I would be very disappointed to find out that 2024 doesn't have the Halo Pelican in it.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Nice little tie-in. A lot of Xbox. Wow.
Mm-hmm. They have a lot of studios.
Xbox.
Baby. Oh, yeah.
Hi, Melina here.
Hellblade
speaking
2.
To you from our performance capture stage at Ninja Theory, where we have just wrapped our shoots for Senua Saga Hellblade 2. When we first showed gameplay for Hellblade 2, it was a look at some of the game's cinematic and immersive action, where Senua faced off against a gigantic troll
Remember
on the Icelandic coastline.
I predicted this would come out last year.
We had it on our fantasy critic.
Yeah. He just looked at me like, you dumbass, and now I understand why.
I mean, it was one of those that's like, if we got it, it was going to be a ton of points.
Journey that awaits you in Senua's saga.
We'll be
what
lucky
you'll
to get this game in
2025. What you'll see all captured by the team on Xbox Series X.
Yeah, if they just wrapped up performance.
In-game footage, so not even engine stuff.
They did say everything was going to have some level of gameplay. So I assume something we saw in the
I think all of their first party stuff.
First party, yeah, that's true. That was the
first party's, yeah, no CGI. So it's all in-game.
Everything's in-engine.
Or at the very least, no pure CGI.
Yeah, so I think even that Star Wars one is technically running in engine. Not that necessarily means anything. She needs
help. Is that Star Wars
that's
one
not,
first
that's
party?
Not first, no.
Yeah,
that's
not first, it's not first
that
party.
That one was all CG because they want to tease the gameplay trailer for tomorrow.
And even in engine doesn't necessarily, like, it doesn't reflect on the actual gameplay at all.
Yo, are we about to hit a new renaissance of Star Wars games with Jedi Survivor and Jedi, the first one, and now this new game?
I love Jedi the first one. That's one of my favorite Star Wars games.
Yeah. Jedi Fallen Order.
I mean, same acronym, FO.
Yeah.
First one. Yeah.
Then don't forget
And then second one,
Lego Skywalker Saga too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is true. There was a long stretch we weren't getting any, and
then you also have LucasArts. You have Amy Hennig working on a game right now too.
Didn't that get canceled? I thought.
No.
Again? Okay.
No, they announced last year that it's being redone again, or rather that she's working on a Star Wars game. They just got the director who was originally working on Star Wars 1313 to come do Amy Hennig's game.
Ooh.
I'll never forget the world for 1313. I will never forgive it.
Same. It's time to fight. And Battlefront 3.
This is what the people
were saying. Or some Out for the Fallen.
And,
I'm here.
This is me on Delta 8, bro.
Yeah, whatever chance of talking.
Like, I don't know about you guys, but for me, it's like I'm getting the voices like all around.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like it.
Where are you? What do
they want? I'm getting Senua everywhere, and then you assholes just like right here. Their
eyes. Delta 8.
They're in my head.
There's a lot of like moist balloon knot looking holes in this trailer, and I'm not about it.
It's real yucky. Yeah. Real yucky trailer so far.
Our soul fought through hell to find us. You were lost.
Not anymore. I didn't play the first Hellblade, but it looked really good.
I've been waiting to play it until this one comes out, but Jesus, I probably should play it now already. I was waiting for Control for Alan Wake 2. And I still haven't played that one.
Control's really good.
Yeah.
I haven't played Control yet either.
Is the first game this trippy?
From what I heard, yeah, because he said the same thing like with the voices all around. What will we do
to us? It's a pretty short experience too, isn't it? Like 8 hours?
It's one of those that I've heard it's really good, but I don't have a good idea of really what like the game is. I've just heard people be like, yeah, it's really good gameplay. That's not just me, right?
No. Not, yeah.
Oh, that's me.
Well,
having issues.
Or did?
Do you want to write this down so we can cut it out?
Hey, more like a dragon.
We find where we were. I had the chat. Closer.
We were definitely closer to like where
it's at
they are
right
now. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, we weren't far behind. It was like about 25 minutes in.
What is that?
They are
waiting.
And we're back.
And we're back.
And we're back.
We're back. Here we go. Sorry. Stream just broke on us. I think there's just so many people watching.
Yeah.
We broke the internet.
We did it. We did it, everybody. Like,
yeah. We Kim K'd it so hard.
Everything I've done has led me to this place. We've come so far, not far enough. Say it. You are ready.
You are all the Jedi.
I really wanted to do like the snap thing that Rey does in Last Jedi.
What if we get lost forever? What will happen to them? What will happen to you?
Show me my parents.
I will not let them down.
She is ready.
Do you ever get nervous?
Who are these around you, Senua? Those you have saved.
24? Okay.
Or those okay. You.
All right, well, there you go, Chance.
I don't believe it. Like,
you're like,
that
fuck
may
you.
Have been in engine. We still haven't seen gameplay, and this was announced in like 2019.
No, it's not.
First one
was
gameplay.
It last year was gameplay?
If they show gameplay and then they don't show gameplay, then something's gone awry, IMO.
Yakuza! New Like a Dragon game, let's go.
I don't know anything about Yakuza, but this guy gives me such Kyle energy with his haircut and his chin strap beard.
It's one of those that I've wanted to play for a really long time. I think they're all on Game Pass now.
Yeah.
But like, I don't have much of a... Well, my man is Nakey.
Naked up.
Yeah,
he's
got that
giggle. Cheeked up on a Tuesday, bro. In Hawaii? Because that'd be very funny.
Has he not realized he's naked yet?
This is very, like, awesome powers as.
Like, the Yakuza games are very funny.
Oh! Oh my god! A stranger!
Is he in like Florida?
Oh, so they're speaking English.
They were speaking English.
Japanese.
Yeah. And there is
yeah, that's cool. Somebody said hang loose. This guy from Hawaii, right?
California, maybe?
Yeah. Got the Ben Affleck tattoo.
His looks way better than Ben's.
Huh?
what's the beam?
The Yakuza games are really, really funny.
Infinite Wealth. I'm all about that.
Okay. Okay.
Like a Dragon, Andrew Tate.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Bethesda.
This is the 10 more seconds of the mountains for Elder Scrolls 6.
Oh, Vault-Tec. Oh, new expansion.
Appalachia, yep, Fallout 76.
What a sight! A verdant wonderland of
progress. I honestly didn't know that this game still had servers going.
Right.
Progress and determined reclamation.
I'm just gonna take a nap.
Million dwellers worth of keen imagination, from the heart of West Virginia to the depths of the pit.
Well, we owe it all to Vault 76.
No matter if you roam alone or spend your time with friends, you'll find a home in Appalachia.
Give us the good clip of Austin freaking out thinking that all three was getting made.
Along with loads of friendly folks to meet and enemies.
I love that this started and everyone just went silent because we're just like, whatever.
Yeah. I can't wait for it to be broken
someday, but not 76.
Yet from Appalachian settlements to Nuka World on tour. You're never short on things to do.
I really like the Americana aesthetic and sound and everything.
Well, how about
but
this? Pack your
not hitting.
For an escape of epicurity.
Yep.
And when was the last time they announced anything for Fallout 76? It's been years, right?
A couple of years ago.
I think it was back when we were still Waypoint. Yeah.
So there you have it.
Yeah, whatever that pit expansion was. Or at least the last I heard anything about it.
Alright, let's go on Steam.
And when you hear adventure calling, when you're looking for some kids,
I know that, like, the biggest issue with 76 came because of the way that it launched and released, but it's wild that, like, this one has, like, such a bad name to it, but, like, Elder Scrolls Online is going very strong.
Oh, yeah.
Atlantic City. Nice.
Cool.
Pretty cool.
I mean, yeah, if you
I like
want
that Game Pass ad. I thought that was cool. Right.
That was nice, yeah.
Back to video games. Is this Banjo-Kazooie?
Ooh.
Capcom! Cap Gods!
A new, Okami?
That would genuinely be very cool.
Are those Gloom Hands?
I'm assuming this isn't Path of Exile. Or not Path of Exile.
It's Capcom.
It's the weirdest Mega Man reboot we've ever got.
Dragon's Dogma, maybe?
Oh yeah, they did announce Dragon's Dogma 2, right?
Doesn't look like it though. Oh. Art style's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Never mind, I hate it. Yuck.
It's like Scorn, but
was Neo Capcom?
I think so.
No.
Or was it? Oh, it's Team Ninja, right?
It's Team Ninja,
yeah.
Yeah,
it's Team Ninja, yeah. What was that, Onimusha?
Alright, I know this is a little delayed, but there's only 20,000 people playing Fallout 76 across all platforms, and I feel like 15,000 of those just happened after that announcement.
Nah, this might just be a new thing. Path of the Goddess, yeah.
It looks cool.
New IP.
Rad. But Capcom doesn't miss right now, man. I bet you that game's gonna be pretty good.
And a Game Pass game too. So,
with Monster Hunter there, I'm hoping that we see a lot of Capcom games start coming to Game Pass. I wouldn't be surprised if, like, next year, after they have like an arcade edition or whatever, Street Fighter 6,
General Motors' historic commitment to performance is embodied in two of its iconic brands, Chevrolet and Cadillac.
I'm looking forward to the new Motorsport, man.
V-Series.R elevates Cadillac's competitive
spirit. They weren't doing any movie trailers.
To a whole new level.
Right?
With its thunderous V8
car commercial in our gaming showcase.
Power. The legendary Corvette.
Management just ends with like, go to your local dealer and lease one for $300.
Yeah. Corvette E-Ray. Well, so I have a question. I don't. None of you guys are car guys, but this General new Chevy. Corvette has been quite divisive because it's like a $60,000 wannabe Ferrari, the way it looks, right? I think I personally don't have anything against it, but
Forza Motorsport and
I think
General
it's an interesting conversation that's happening.
I wouldn't be against a car that looks like a Ferrari for a quarter of the price. I just don't know if I'd want it to be a Corvette because I'm not a huge car guy, but I know that that's like the little dick man in a midlife crisis car.
It started out as the pilot car, and then everybody in the midlife crisis started buying them.
I'm all about the appearance of wealth and intelligence, Chance, so I'm about that car.
Okay, because that's kind of where I'm getting at, is like you get a really, really fun,
$300,000
car
for $60,000. And like relatively, it's a good looking car and relatively affordable, like as opposed to a Ferrari, you know what I mean? I don't see anything wrong with it.
Yeah. Like, I'd rent it on a vacation.
Yeah,
old boss rented one, and I got to take it around the block, and it was pretty fun. One.
Nice.
I will not lie.
Beats have been hot this showcase, man.
Yeah. Remember when they had like 3 years in a row where they brought like a car on stage and then hopped around for 2 seconds and lifted it out?
Gotta pay them bills, bro. The lighting in this is so insane.
The graphics in this game are genuinely unbelievable. Yeah.
Playing this on PC, man. Like max settings.
An RTX 4090.
This is my timeline. I mean that for car people, like having like brand new or like experimental cars that like aren't out yet, like available in the game, I think is a really big deal. Like my uncle's a big like Chevy guy in particular, and so with him having this new Stingray in there, I'm sure he's all about it. Like that's cool. I get them pushing. It was like, hey, we've got these two dope ass cars that are going to be a big part of this game. Like that makes sense to me.
I've also always loved concept cars.
Forza in and of itself is like it's a known quantity. We know it's going to slap.
Oh yeah.
Elder Scrolls Online.
Most likely. I have seen betrayal.
Yep. Endurance.
Yep.
Skyrim again.
I mean, you do go to Skyrim in here, so.
I am the one who knows.
I think you're saying like ESO still has a crazy amount of players. Like that's an MMO that is still running really strong.
Yeah.
Well, wasn't it last year when they gave out like all the expansions for free or something like that?
Mm-hmm. I think it was for a limited time, but yeah.
So it was just like, hey, just go have at it. Ending existence,
I feel. Yeah, there was like a month-long period or something where all of them were on Game Pass or something like that.
I think the base game still is.
Base game is.
Yeah, base game.
Base game, and I think a couple of the earlier expansions are free.
That sounds right, yeah.
Looks like this is tied to Morrowind / like the first Dragonborn.
Give me them dodge rolls, baby. I didn't know this game had that. I might have to try it.
He's like, wait a minute, there's a roll?
Yeah, they got a parry? Because then I'm in.
Can you parry in PvP?
Yeah, I guess in Bloodborne PvP.
Necron.
Oh, you're talking about this.
That's very soon.
Necron Shadow.
Next week. Is this like a new announcement, or like did people know about that?
C-16 at 37.
I don't pay attention to ESO news.
By Null Sector.
There's something different about Null Sector this time.
Remember when they changed the whole monetization of the game for the single player?
Remember when they said, yeah. Remember when they were going to launch an entire campaign and then said, never mind?
Yep.
And today we're here to tell you that you will get that campaign in Overwatch 3.
Oh yeah, and remember when they replaced Overwatch with a shittier version of Overwatch, and now it's impossible to play the original version of Overwatch?
Yep.
Blizzard seems to be one that's like kind of fallen from grace lately. They haven't met some very
I wouldn't even say kind of. I think they're in the dirt, dude.
Yeah.
Diablo 4 is the only good thing they've done in the last like 10 years.
That, I guess that's where it's coming from, is I'm seeing everybody play Diablo, so there's a lot of Blizzard love, but like... But I'm picking up reports. I don't know. All my friends who play Call of Duty competitively or anything are not happy with Activision Blizzard and then.
Oh yeah, I mean it just feels like bad decisions on all fronts. Like on top of all of like the on top of all like the codec and behind the scenes shit too. Like it's just Blizzard's in a rough spot.
Someone should buy them.
I think somebody's trying.
They're trying real hard.
Yeah. Oh, wow, they're just introducing a firing range.
Yeah.
The world is counting on us.
So this should have been when they actually launched Overwatch 2. Not last year.
I used to love Overwatch. That would have gotten me excited like a few years ago.
Fight with me.
Engage it.
Never even played it.
I mean, it's not worth your time at this point, right? Like,
yeah.
It's got a really, really bad monetization system now with the new.
I wonder what differentiates that story thing they just talked about versus what they can. Because the original was solo, like single player.
Oh, let's go. This is what I'm excited for.
25 Tactica.
What is this place?
Tactics, yep. Looks like
we're in what is that art style? What's going on?
Look, it's similar to like the Persona 5 Q games that were on 3DS. But this is essentially.
Can you get us out of here?
Think Fire Emblem and Persona.
So you're telling me you're thieves who steal hearts, and you just happen to stumble into this world? The Rebel Corps will always help the Phantom.
This is a new song too.
Just as the Phantom Thieves have helped.
And so new Persona music, I am down for, because that is one of my favorite soundtracks of all time.
You should be grateful to have been made my subjects, but you're just matterless little brats. Unfortunately, returning will be no easy feat. Somewhere deep inside, I know you realize things can't go on like this.
Yeah.
So, will you take a stand beside us? Yeah. Let's show them what we got.
Oh, the all-out attack. Some of them attacked. Okay.
Cool.
Okay. This month, and it's on Game Pass. Let's go.
Persona's one I never thought we'd see at an Xbox showcase. I'm not gonna lie.
It used
that was
wild, just be PlayStation.
Right? It is. They're dishing the wallet out for sure to get some of these.
It really sounds like Xbox is, or not even sounds, looks like St. Xbox Louis. Is making an effort to better their relations with Japanese publishers. Because I mean, even Capcom and what was the other one I was just thinking about? Sega, like, didn't used to have that relationship. The
wonder. Oh, is this Starfield?
It is.
Getting a little tease.
Yeah. So I see we're at the end of the showcase then.
But that we have measured it.
I'm sure it's just a tease, just to be like, hey, stay tuned after.
I mean, this game needs to be. You put your little gameplay stinger up front. Like, this is the stuff that'll get like huge amount of views on YouTube and things, right?
Oh yeah.
Like,
so this morning, actually, I went to the Bethesda YouTube channel and I watched last year's 15-minute deep dive, and I watched all the Into the Starfield kind of documentary-esque things they've put out over the past year and a half, kind of rehype, remember what they've talked to me or what they've talked to the people about, and like, I feel like the pressure on this game is high and rightfully so, but like the standard at which it needs to past the bar needs to be lowered. I think it needs to be the next evolution of Bethesda, not the next evolution of all of Xbox, if that makes sense.
Yeah, they're putting way too much onus on this game. In my opinion, it's going to be a 7.5 out of 8. It's not going to run smoothly because of how ambitious it is. And I really think everybody's saying that this is the make it or break it moment for Xbox. That was Halo Infinite. That's not this game. Like, in my opinion.
This game needs to be a solid win for Xbox,
and I think it also needs to...
It can't be a 6. That's more of where I'm coming from. Like, it can be an 8, and they'll be fine, but if it's a 6, they're in trouble. They themselves, I think, are the ones that are putting too much on this game.
I would have liked to have gotten a little bit of Halo news or something, even if it's just like, hey, this is, like, the next season update, here's some new maps or something. Like, it's... I hate seeing... Or I hate not seeing Halo at these things constantly.
The fact that we didn't see Halo Infinite at all during this showcase is pretty telling.
That's been teased. The end of this road,
a rumored.
Will change humanity.
Really.
That's pretty cool.
Now, given this, that's a better trailer than I've seen for it yet. You know what I mean? Like, I was like, that actually looks like a fun game. Which none of the other trailers ever did for me.
It's where we belong.
I even think holding it up to the standard of Skyrim is really high. Like, I feel like this needs to be this generation's Witcher, not even this generation's Skyrim, if that makes sense.
Whoa. Six. Whoa. Wow.
Don't throw any shade at Witcher 3.
No,
I would say that's
a
better game and bigger achievement.
I'm not saying it in a shady way. I'm talking more at the, like, what we think of Skyrim, a game,
love
a single
logo,
player game
that
over 10 years later still has people putting time into it. Whereas The Witcher, I never heard of anybody talk bad about
World
The Witcher, but I don't think it reached
the
mainstream appeal.
I think
Skyrim.
It's depending on the crowd you roll with, because at least in my side or in my social sphere, it is definitely Witcher 3 over Skyrim. I know we're probably the outcast, but...
I'm more talking, like mainstream in terms of like... Like what people say. I feel like The Witcher 3 couldn't have been that big without Skyrim, if that makes sense.
Here's the thing, and I think we can just get ahead of this right now. It's not gonna be good.
Yeah, fair enough. I agree.
I disagree. I think it's gonna be a good Bethesda RPG. I don't think it's gonna reinvent the wheel of gaming.
If this game comes out and it's broken and it doesn't receive the Cyberpunk 2077 treatment, I'm not taking game journalism serious ever again.
I don't
give them a pass anymore. Like, they have the funding, they have the time. They've canceled or delayed that game like 5 years. No excuses, Bethesda. I'm talking to you.
Yeah, what's this?
I haven't said yet. It's a world premiere, though.
World premiere.
Was it 127 hour simulator?
I do like the idea of like a
mountaineering,
like
game.
like a rock climbing, like based game. I think there's a lot of cool opportunities for neat stuff like that. Like almost like the Death Stranding kind of like, what if we took this one thing and made that the focus of the gameplay, right?
I'm not gonna lie, they are being pretty brave considering like this movement was my least favorite part of like Assassin's Creed, because it's so hard to get right. But if that's what this game is focused on, I have to imagine they put a lot of time into that type of traversal, like Death Stranding did.
And I like seeing like the tools that they're using and stuff, like taking like the line and stuff and putting it in and.
Yeah.
Wow, that looks interesting. I'll play it.
Jusson.
Game Pass.
What was that?
Jusson.
Just Ant.
Just
Ant.
Just Ant. I keep forgetting they have a voiceover for it, and I do it like instinctually.
Because they stopped doing it for a while.
Chinese Super Room.
Never heard of
them.
We got the jams though. Waterworld game.
I got a little bit of cold chills. I'm liking this.
We got another oil rig.
Deepwater Horizon, the game.
It's gonna get spooky. I can just feel it.
Yeah, I'm getting like, I feel like it's gonna be Dead Space, but instead of on a ship, it's on a rig.
Dead water.
What's that Meg knockoff movie where the shark's attacking the oil rig?
Still wakes the deep.
That title goes hard.
I love a good water scary game. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Ocean scary.
More unknown than space.
Yeah,
our oceans.
The only thing scarier than a spider is a shark.
Not wrong there.
And that's why I'm here to present to you the spider shark.
releasing it in 2025.
Tarantula legs.
Yeah.
God.
This looks cool.
Yeah. But you got a sword and a skateboard in your game? I'm on board.
With this
and
art
a really
style.
Cool art style. I was gonna say, really cool art style.
This is something I play baked. Like, it's very chill, calming, but still gives you stuff to do.
Yo, blast it out of your mind on Delta H.
Bro, I'm gonna have to try Delta 10. You know what I mean? I'm gonna get to the next level.
Engines of Hinterberg. It's a cool aesthetic, man.
Yeah.
I always like the mix of sort of like mundane and fantastical, like at the same time. Like, you had like towns and cars and all that stuff, but also monsters and magic.
Hey.
Hi. I'm very excited.
What the fuck?
To be with
he's here.
Johnny Silverhand.
He's there.
The upcoming expansion for Cyberpunk 2077.
Do we get Idris Elba
Phantom
on stage?
Phantom Liberty. Mm-hmm. This new adventure reunites Johnny and V on a dangerous spy mission.
I am actually looking forward to this.
I want this to be what gets me into Cyberpunk.
I have a fucking Johnny Silverhand vest and I can't find it.
Be a part of this game like, with you, man. Despite its flaws, like I thought the story of Cyberpunk was fun.
You'll get to visit Dogtown,
and I enjoyed the world and stuff, and so like they've had the time to address a lot of the problems with Cyberpunk. I'm hoping now that they can release this and have it be solid.
Expect a massive expansion. Twists, secrets, and plenty of stuff to do. I know the team at CD Projekt.
There's not many people I like more than Keanu Reeves.
It's impossible to dislike
stories
them.
And video
right.
games.
It's very.
And I really
there's something about him that's so pure.
This guy sucks.
I will boot you out of the call, man. Come on.
You gotta get clicks, man.
You ruined my layout.
And so it is my honor and pleasure to give you and introduce the official trailer. For Phantom
Let's
Liberty.
Go.
Let's fucking go, baby.
Check it out.
Check it out.
He's so funny, dude. I love him. He's so funny, bro.
Oh, we're getting Girl V. It. Let's fucking go.
Good. That's what I played with.
Johnny. Yeah. My V was hot as fuck.
The voice actress was way
There's
better,
nothing
too.
Can stop that. V. My name is Songbird. I'm an NUS intelligence analyst.
This soundtrack. I forgot how good the music in this game was.
And I can save Steam Deck life. Verified too, if anyone What's wants to kind of chip away at it in bed, you know what I mean?
Attention all Dogtown residents. President managed to crash her space force.
Do you think that Xbox was able just to get the marketing deal with CD Projekt Red, or do we think Cyberpunk's coming to Game Pass?
No, they've been doing most of the marketing for CD. For Cyberpunk, it was always Xbox doing the majority.
Okay. That's where we saw Keanu at E3.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
Get Myers out of there. Time to evac. Her safety is the top priority.
Shit!
They catch us out here, we're dead. Wait, hear that?
God almighty, it's moving!
Oh, dang.
Avengers?
That does look like the giant robot she used to fight in Avengers.
Someone ratted us out.
You know, V, treason ain't ever black and white.
Yeah.
It's a charade, V.
Wherever she goes, people get hurt. Bodies drop.
Just want what Songbird promised me. The cure.
Situation has changed. Need to know if you're with me.
Illusion of freedom draws in the desperate. Pick your truth, V.
Come on. Got iron in your hand. Gotta put it to someone's head. Pull the trigger.
I wonder if this is gonna change the endings.
That's
the option for the endings. Or if this takes place after some of the endings, because like in mine,
September 26th.
Hey, that's right before my birthday. Let's go. Happy birthday.
That's probably the next game I'll play after Tears of the Kingdom once I'm finished with that fucking game. I'm really hyped for that. That looked really fucking good.
Yeah, that
looks excellent. I'm positive on it. You know what I mean? Like I really hope it's good.
As a Cyberpunk apologist, I really hope this.
I'm not quite apologist, but I'm optimistic. Is it SimCity?
Oh no, City Skylines 2, I think.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Billy the Door.
They're all the same.
Shout out, Billy.
I promise not to destroy your cities with tsunami.
I don't.
The ultimate landlord.
Mother
Landlord's
Nature.
Simulator.
What is God if not just the landlord of Earth?
And I'm a believer. Yeah, look at all that rent you could charge.
Yeah. I would be so toxic in this, just make a roundabout that like goes like 50 times. Like.
I mean, you can.
Coal.
That clean coal energy.
Right.
Not only are you God, but your big brother watching everybody do, go about their daily lives. Making sure those trucks get where they need to go.
Yeah.
And Game Pass.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm happy for these fans.
Yep. Hanging on this a little long here.
Wait, what game was that?
World premiere.
They really should get John St. John to do that.
I know, right? More Atlas.
Did the fired social media manager forget to fake post or forget to wrongly post a third video?
This is probably Shin Megami Tensei game, most likely.
Do you think this is five being ported?
I can see that, yeah.
SMT5 was what? Only PlayStation and Switch?
I don't think it was PlayStation.
It was just Switch. Okay.
Yeah, don't quote me on that, but yeah, I think it might have been Switch.
Okay, that's what I thought, but I was like, no, but Persona's always on PlayStation as well. Clearly, if the Switch can run it, the PlayStation can.
Yeah, one of those weird.
The Switch can run it, your phone can.
Yeah. Cool animation. I'll say that.
Metaphor? Interesting. New IP.
What was that little tooth for the eye? The dot in the eye?
I'm assuming it's like, you know, every Persona game has like a little world mascot kind of character. So I'm assuming that's probably just that.
Is their little mascot is your tooth?
Xbox.
Ooh.
Banner.
Good game flows. If you're looking for some good strategy games.
Our people's only means of survival is to seek sanctuary here, in the Belfry. You must explore this world.
Oh, this is like their Advance Wars?
To find the origins of this evil.
But in the past. Unadvanced
and
wars.
And bring hope. Back to our people.
Uncivilized
wars.
Co-op.
Like
the DLC character
Guerrilla Warfare
is Obi-Wan Kenobi.
I would think I beat him.
I like that graphics there.
In an ever-changing world, so this one's probably still procedurally generated.
I love me a good cel-shaded art style.
Are you thinking online multiplayer, or is it just companions?
It said co-op.
Oh, it did say co-op. Okay.
Together, you can save humanity.
Tower Born.
Cool.
You know, I thought the Born at the end of stuff had like gone out of style in 2020, but
still doing it.
Living.
Still doing it, baby. We living.
We can keep the Borns, but we gotta stop with the Gates.
World premiere.
Man, they're still cranking.
Mm-hmm. Ah, yeah.
I'm always on board the moment you get that like 20s steampunky like Americana inspired, like very like Bioshock Infinite looking. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Yep.
Sucker for it.
Bioshock. Let's bring him back. Delicately balanced machine.
But it only takes one rebellious little gear to ruin everything. If you resist, yeah,
very steampunk,
very Bioshocky, Dishonored almost.
Yeah.
If you alter,
yeah, I was getting Dishonored vibes too.
If you threaten what I have built.
Nice mohawk.
There is nowhere in space or time where I will not destroy you.
Oh, jeez. Oh, damn.
I wasn't expecting that.
Yeah.
Oh, so you're messing around with time. That's cool.
It reminds me of Deathloop as well, not in the fact
right?
that it's not like they have the same aesthetic, but they are both doing the same thing with different aesthetics.
Oh no. What did I do?
Any last words?
Very Bioshock.
Before my friend puts one in your scalp.
Clock.
Two beers.
Oh.
Revolution.
Nice.
That's
awesome. I thought they were just about to release a game called fucking Clock.
Yeah, in due time. That's awesome.
I was like, okay, just calling it Clock. And I was like, Clockwork.
Thank you all
okay.
for joining us. Today is a special day for me and the team.
Hey, baby boy.
I'm excited to see 11 games showcased from our first party studios. We opened with Fable from
Woo!
Playground Games, which will bring the franchise into the modern era while staying true to its British style and humor.
Compulsion it did look really faithful to the original. Like,
shared their mm-hmm. first original experiences since joining Xbox with South of Midnight and Clockwork Revolution. And we are thrilled at how Avowed mm-hmm. is shaping up for release next year from the RPG masters at Obsidian. In addition to Avowed, our studios will deliver Hellblade 2, an all-new Microsoft Flight Simulator, Towerborn, and more in 2024. Later this month, players can look forward to Elder Scrolls Online Necrom and Sea of Thieves Monkey Island.
Starfield is the first
As
domino.
We look to holiday, we
it's
will
supposed
launch
to be Halo
Starfield
Infinite. It was supposed to be Redfall.
And Forza Motorsport, both built for Xbox Series X, S, and PC. We are also honored to share 14 games today from our creative
What's
partners.
What's the shirt he's wearing, Hexen?
Like Star Wars Outlaws from Ubisoft Massive in collaboration with Lucasfilm Games.
Woo!
33 Immortals from Thunder Lotus, Kunitsugami, Path of the Goddess from Capcom,
oh, Kunitsugami.
And more Persona games coming to Game Pass thanks to our continued partnership with Sega Atlas. I'd also like to congratulate the Studio Zero team.
Atlas is owned by Sega?
ReFantazio.
Yeah.
It's great to be able to premiere what is next from the creators of Persona here in our showcase.
Oh,
we are focused on putting our players and game creators first in everything.
From 1995.
No matter
if
it's
so Spencer's out here flexing.
PC,
is he gonna do it for one more thing?
All gamers are welcome here at Xbox.
Woohoo! Happy Pride.
When it comes to our consoles, we have heard your feedback on two fronts. First, we have significantly increased our supply of Xbox Series X, making it easier for fans to find globally. Second, we know you've wanted more storage with Xbox Series S, and I'm excited to share we have some news there as well.
Bro, this Xbox Series S is one of the hottest looking consoles ever made.
It does look really, really good. Like, it's just a sexy little box.
Back in
black.
What I mean?
Ooh. S?
Yeah. That's clean.
Yeah.
Clean, yeah. I've been considering, like
one terabyte.
It's got a terabyte in it?
I mean, it's what they should have launched with all, like, from the start. Like, with how big
these
games are
not
going to disrupt.
It's the box is, like, that big.
Digital only.
Yeah. I mean, a terabyte.
It legit can fit in my backpack.
Oh, yeah. 349 though. Okay.
Yeah, so it's a little bit more expensive, but yeah, it makes sense.
How much is the Series X?
500.
Five,
maybe?
400. Oh,
and now for the one more thing you've all
That's
been
a really,
for.
If it's 400 or 500.
Prepare for the most comprehensive deep dive we've ever done for the biggest game we've ever built.
Starfield time, bitches.
So sit tight and enjoy Starfield Direct.
It's $500. Right. So being $150 less, I think that's a really good price point for that Series S.
And you want to hit pause?
Yeah.
Yeah, awesome. All right, well, that was the Xbox Summer Games Showcase, the not E3, the key three, if you will, of the year. Before we go on, general thoughts, how are you guys feeling? Did y'all enjoy that?
Yeah, that was way better than PlayStation. I think it didn't get me as hyped as Summer Games Fest, but I'd give that like a solid 4 out of 5. That was a really good showcase. Gave us a lot more to hope for Xbox besides Starfield. I've hated this line of thinking that Starfield's the only thing that can save them. There's a bunch of games here that I'm really stoked for, and they're all coming to Game Pass, which is such a win.
It felt like a strong showing. Yeah, it felt like a strong showing. A lot of that's coming in Game Pass. Also, I'm a sucker. You put Star Wars in it, I'm probably going to enjoy it. And so the surprise of seeing Massive's game early was very, very fun. Opening with Fable is such a, like, swinging your dick out right on the table move. You know what I mean? Just being like, what's up? We've got it. It's here.
And having that dude be a giant, too. Just, like, it looked like a regular dude, like, for most of it. And then just, boom.
Excellent.
That shot of him right there.
Yeah.
Like,
and then they fucking killed him.
But honestly, like, for Xbox, this need, like, I think they came out, they proved they have games coming, like, you know, everybody's every year it's like, you know, they no release dates, you know, these studio that they've acquired, nothing they're showing. You got, you know, that studio, not just one game, they have two games that the Stand By Midnight and then Clockwork Revolution. Honestly, Clockwork Revolution might be my game of the showcase. Like, that looked so
that
cool.
One looks sick.
And like a bunch of games coming to Game Pass. Like, it was unfortunate that the Persona games leaked early. Because honestly, if those wouldn't have leaked, like, this would have easily been 5 out of 5 showcase.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Any more thoughts? We all good?
No, like, no jaw dropping, like, stunning reveals, but they had just a ton of quality announcements, whereas like PlayStation and Summer Game Fest, it was like one or two. So this was easily so far the best showcase, and
agree.
Yeah, it's exciting to be a Xbox gamer right now.
Yeah, it really is, man. And I think they're kind of like on the upswing. Shout out to Cyberpunk as well. I thought that trailer was genuinely very, very good, and I've saying high hope sounds weird, but like I'm optimistic about that one. I think they've had the time to kind of like iron out the kinks, and hopefully that's a really fun story. Jordan, I know you're really excited about Starfield, so we will go ahead and end this one right here. Did you like the conference as much as we did? Please let us know down in the comments below. Like, comment, subscribe, go follow us all on Twitter. We all have individual ones. We have a shared screens one. And go play an Xbox game today. All right? We'll see you guys later.
Hit Game Pass.
Mm-hmm.